or either have hypertension, they have diabetes, they have other metabolic disorders, or they have cancer, they have comorbidities, and their immune profile is on the lower side, they have liver disease, they have chronic kidney disease, so on and so forth. As and when we find that these people with these comorbidities, their immune status is on the lower side, the virus does not attack them particularly. It is the pathology that overrides the system, the defense mechanism of a particular body. And with the advanced age, this defense is on the lower side. I think my particular reference would be, again, it's not how we develop the immunity. Our immunity has to be not only at individual level, but at community level, at herd level also. That can be done only, as I said, by teaching programs, by education, by public awareness, by having a good lifestyle, by taking proper food which is cooked properly. We try to avoid which is contaminated, or observing hygienic principles, not only personal hygiene, but at community level also. We must look at the surroundings also, keep them clean, not only ourselves, but the home, the surroundings, the streets, and so on and so forth. I think that's very, very important. As long as we do it, we probably not be avoiding the COVID-19, but we'll be avoiding many other evolving viruses that are going to affect us in due course of time. If you see the health sector all over the world, there are countries that are developing, that are evolving, and where, if you take our own country, our GDP, the spend on this health care is just around 2.5 or something. And as long as you have 2.5 GDP being spent on the healthcare sector, probably you're going to have a decimal health infrastructure. Compared to the countries like US, Italy, France, European people, where they usually spend around 18% of their GDP. However, in spite of that much of involvement in the health structure or development of the health infrastructure in those countries, you have seen how they're crumbling, how US is crumbling on that front, how Spain, Italy, and all other European countries, even England, they're facing the heat. The only country in Europe that has been able to probably restrict it is Germany so far, as where the data are close. But we need to evolve our health infrastructure development from basics, from primary health centers to district health level centers to medical college levels to tertiary care centers or in medical universities. So at all the modes, at all the levels, we need to invest in terms of not only developing the manpower, but the equipment, but the machinery, adapting to the latest technologies. We see the best of the centers in the world, how they are trying to cope up with this pandemic, yet they are struggling with it. We are no exception. And Sheri Kashmir Institute of Medical Sciences, again, is no exception there. However, as I said, I salute my all frontline workers, my team management, my doctors, my faculty, in particular, Dr. Ajaz, Dr. Farooq, Dr. Chiyachitu, Dr. Sunawala, Dr. Madhasar, Dr. Suhey, who have been so far in the front line. My all other frontline senior residents, I don't remember the names, the junior resident doctors, the paramedics, the nurses, the other supportive services, one and all, they have put their best, they took the risks when nobody was willing to, but they took the lead, they are in the forefront, they're doing the best, and I'm proud of them, I salute them.